Please stand as you are able.
My love, here I stand before you. I am yours now. From this moment on,
the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Yep, you got to respond, and also with you, okay? Try again. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Dear friends, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Vanessa and Kyle, to surround them with our prayers, and to share in their joy. Vanessa, will you have Kyle to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. And Kyle, will you have Vanessa to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. And will you, the families and friends gathered here to celebrate with Vanessa and Kyle, support and care for them, sustain and pray for them in times of trouble, give thanks with them in times of joy, honor the bonds of their covenant, and affirm the love of God reflected in their life together? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Let us pray. Gracious God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to reveal your love to all people. Enrich Vanessa and Kyle with every good gift, that their life together may show forth your love. And grant that at the last we may all celebrate with Christ the marriage feast that has no end. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Today's reading is from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father, through him. And now a poem, Blessing of the Hands. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours, as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
Grace to you in peace from God our Father and from our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. At first reading, this passage from St. Paul's letter to the Colossians doesn't seem to fit at a wedding. Paul is addressing the members of the Colossian church, instructing them on how they are to live together. The congregation was made up of all sorts of people. There were Jews and non-Jews, men and women, people who were slaves, people who owned slaves, high society and the poorest of the poor, people of Roman, Greek, Jewish, and Turkish ancestry. There was quite a variety of people. Paul addresses this diversity by reminding the members of their common bond, that their common bond is the love of all of them, a love that they've been given in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. It is through this love that they are given the power to show compassion and kindness, humility and patience to each other. It is through this love that they are given the power to bear with each other, forgive each other, live in harmony with each other. And most of all, by clothing themselves in this love, they will be bound together as brothers and sisters in faith. Now, why is there this stress on love? It is through this love that they have received and continue to receive through Jesus that is the foundation that powers all else. This is good advice from Paul, not only for the Christians of that first century church, but for the Christians of the 21st century as well. Okay, I got it, Pastor Dale. Paul is giving good advice on how to live together as brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, but how does this address what we have gathered for this afternoon? Well, the same advice Paul gives to the Colossian congregation can be applied to the relationship we are celebrating today, Vanessa and Kyle becoming husband and wife. It can be applied, for today's ceremony is not some type of magic event. What I mean is that after this day, Kyle and Vanessa will not automatically live happily ever after. They're never going to, like, from now on, they'll always agree with one another, they'll never have any disagreements, everything will be smooth sailing. Those of you who have some years of marriage behind you know that to make a marriage go, it takes work. Hard work. It takes open communication, honest talking, and listening. It takes not being afraid to share what one is thinking and feeling, and not on the surface, but in the guts. It takes patience and humility. In a survey of couples who have been married from 20 years all the way through 70 years, the number one response to how did you make your marriage last was putting the needs of your spouse first. Now, this is not easy for us to do as human beings, even though we have promised, even to those we have promised to love. And that is why Paul's words are appropriate to address the relationship of the marriage. For in their marriage, Vanessa and Kyle will need to do the same. Clothe themselves with compassion and kindness, humility and patience. Lots of patience. They must learn to bear with one another, forgive one another, live in harmony with one another. And most of all, just as the Colossians were to do, they too need to clothe themselves with the love of Christ. For it is this love and its power that will be their foundation as well. A foundation that will enable them to be patient, to communicate, share feelings, forgive, to love. Without this love as the foundation, as the wedding liturgy states, marriage can become a burden. For we as human beings have a limit to our patience and love. But with this love as a foundation, it enhances their joys. And it will sustain them in their struggles. Again, as the wedding liturgy states, it is through this love that we can be sustained and have our joy restored. And so, as we celebrate this afternoon, Vanessa and Kyle becoming husband and wife, let us celebrate and give thanks for the foundation that will enable them to be there for each other through the best and the worst of what is to come. And in fact, it enables each one of us to be there for each other in whatever relationship we are in. To the best of the love they have, the love we all have, in, with, and through Jesus Christ. The Lord God, in his goodness, created us male and female, and by the gift of marriage found a human community. In a joy that begins now and is brought to perfection in the life to come. Because of sin, our age-old rebellious slash marriage continues still to bless it with his abundant and ever-present support. We can be sustained in our weariness and have our joy restored. Vanessa and Kyle, if it is your intention to share with each other your joys and sorrows and all that the years will bring, with your promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife. Just try to face each other. I take you, Kyle, to be my husband. And these things I promise you. I will be faithful to you and honest with you. I will obey and respect, trust, help, and care for you. I will share my life with you. I will forgive you as we have been forgiven. And I will try with you to better understand ourselves, the world, and God, through the best and the worst of what is to come, until death parts us. I take you, Vanessa, to be my wife, and these things I promise you. I will be faithful to you and honest with you. I will obey and respect, trust, help, and care for you. I will share my life with you. I will forgive you as we have been forgiven. And I will try with you to better understand ourselves, the world, and God through the best and the worst of what is to come until death parts us. We give you thanks, O God, of grace for your love and faithfulness to your people. May these rings be a symbol of the promise Vanessa and Kyle have made with each other. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Kyle, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Vanessa, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Vanessa and Kyle, by their promises before God and in the presence of this assembly, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife. Blessed be the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, and to endure the cross for our sake that we may have abundance of life. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing on Vanessa and Kyle. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let your love be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them so that their lives together may bear witness to your love. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. As a sign of their new life together, as husband and wife, Vanessa and Kyle will light this unity candle. The action is a reminder of the words from Genesis chapter 2 that tells us in marriage, the two become one. And a new life, a new relationship, a new family has begun.
Because it made all
We praise you, O God, for the joy that Vanessa and Kyle have found in each other. And we pray that their love and faithfulness may reflect your gracious love and enrich our common life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give to Vanessa and Kyle gentleness and patience, affection and understanding, readiness to trust one another, and when they hurt each other, grace to acknowledge their fault and to give and receive forgiveness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Use us to support Vanessa and Kyle in their lives together. Give us such a sense of your constant love that we may employ all our strength in a life of praise of you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Father, you bless the family and renew your people. Enrich husbands and wives, parents and children more and more with your grace that, strengthening and supporting each other, they may serve those in need and be a sign of the fulfillment of your perfect kingdom, where with your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign one God through all ages of ages. Gathered in one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may God Almighty send you light and truth to keep you all the days of your life. The hand of God protect you, the holy angels accompany you, and the blessings of Almighty God the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen. I have great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Churston.